This is the Goddess Sessions. My name is Devatara. Welcome back, my wonderful soul friends. Fulshir Arash Mo Alam Korja Infak. Today we're here to embrace the energy of the waxing moon. It is a time of motivation, commitment, momentum, and thus taking inspired action towards those seeds that we planted at the new moon. It corresponds to women's inner spring, day 7 to 14, which is the dynamic and follicular stage, moving from yin to yang energy. The moon is in Sagittarius, the eternal optimist. It is the seeker of freedom and adventure, and its motto is, I seek. Sagittarius is related to the sacral, the hips, the thighs, the liver, and also sciatica. So today's practice is going to correlate to that. The props that you'll need today would be blocks, perhaps a belt, a pillow. If you'd like to set an atmosphere, light some incense, aromatherapy, burn some sage to cleanse the energy, and put on a lovely, slow, relaxing playlist, please do so now for this yin yoga practice. And then meet me back here on the mat. In whatever pose is comfortable for you. So I'm going to come to a rock pose as long as the spine is straight. Bring the shoulders up, back and down, away from the ears. Allow the eyes to close. And now bring your attention into the pelvis. Your sacral chakra, the energy center related to our emotions. It's our sexual center and also connected to relationships. If you wish, you can place your hand on your pelvis. Breathing in through the nose. And out through the mouth, allowing the breath to move into the chest and into the belly. And letting the breath center us and bring us into the present moment. Becoming aware of the sacral. As you breathe deep. Our most important relationship in life is with ourselves. So during this practice, honor yourself. Allow people, circumstances, situations to be cleared from your mind. This is your time, your space to focus on you. And let all else fall away. Few more deep breaths. Grounding you in the present moment. One last deep breath and sighing out. Allow the eyes to open. And now for some pranayama, we're going to do humming bee. So we're going to place our fingers in our ears in a moment. You're going to inhale through the nose, and on the exhale, hum out. And this relaxes the nervous system, relaxes the nerves. So fingers in the ears, you can place the fingers over the eyes. Inhale. Exhale, hum. Mm-hmm. Last time. Relax the arms down by the sides of the body. And now we're going to move on to the belly as we move into Sphinx pose. So bringing the elbows underneath the shoulders. Fingers spread out as they ground into the earth. Looking forward, shoulder bones wide. Opening the chest, opening the heart chakra. Allow the eyes to close. And as this is yin yoga, and we're going to be holding the pose, listen to your body. Move down or up, staying at a comfortable position. Becoming aware of the lower back and allowing it to soften. Breathing deep on the inhale, softening on the exhale. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath. Now, if that was quite intense for you, I want you to come back onto your knees, toes touching, knees wide, keeping the hips down towards the bottom. Slowly walk the hands forward, drop the head, and stay in extended child pose. And if your body is asking for more, we're going to move into seal. Bringing the hands out slightly wider than the mat. Looking forward, relaxing the lower back, relaxing the legs. Chest, heart chakra shining forward. And again, listen to your body, moving into it deeper. Or lessening these, making the pose easier. giving attention to the sensations in the body, noticing any muscles that you're holding on. Let go, allow them to soften and relax. Listening to your body's needs right now in the present moment without judgment. And instead with acceptance and allowance. The poses today are very good for sciatica and some of the spiritual and emotional reasons for sciatica is taking on too much, overworking, overstressing your body. So really connect in with your body, listen to it, allow it to guide you. Flow with its needs. Remembering this is your practice, and if you need to move on to the belly, come into extended child pose. Use your intuition. Acknowledge your needs. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath, sighing out. Allow the belly to move into the earth. Allow the forehead to move on to the palms for 5 deep breaths. As the body softens and relaxes. Now bring the palms underneath the shoulders, elbows in towards the spine, pushing up, and slowly walking the hands back. And when we come out of a pose in Yin Yoga, it's normal to feel a little achy because we're holding the pose for so long and the poses are getting into the ligaments. So slowly coming out, listening to the body, respecting it, not abusing it. If you have a block, hopefully you do, or a bolster if you don't, We're going to move into supported bridge. So come into a lying down position. Slowly listen to the body. Feet planted and grounded into the earth. Slowly using your core, bringing the core upwards, and then place, depending on your body, the block at the easiest, mid, or top. Remembering you can change this throughout the practice. I'm going to start personally on the middle, and I'm placing it under my hips. So it's the flat part of the back. And relaxing into the pose, allowing the block to do the work. Again, becoming more of the sacral. And become aware of the white light, a ball of white energy, the sacral is white, and we use the fifth dimensional chakra system. It's overseen by Archangel Gabriel. And you can call upon him to help clear any blocks and cleanse the energy in your sacral. So you can be more in tune and honor your emotions, your sexuality, and have more harmonious relationships with yourself, with others, and with your environment. Checking that the front of the hips are soft, the knees, the thighs, the arms, the shoulders, your face and head. in more deep breaths. One last deep breath, sign it. Gently raise the hips and take the block away, moving it to the side, slowly vertebra by vertebra, moving the spine towards the earth. Allow the knees to come together. And take five long, deep breaths. Relaxing the spine. And then bringing your belt towards you. We're going to do reclined extended leg pose. So looping the belt around your foot, you can keep, to make it easier, the opposite leg bent or straight. See what feels good for you and then slowly lengthen through the leg, making sure it's comfortable. It's okay to have the knee bent, listen to your body. This is your practice. Only you know what feels right in your body. This pose lengthens the lower spine, the hamstrings, the calves. By keeping the foot flexed, it lengthens the Achilles. Check that the leg resting on the earth is soft, relaxed. Moving further in or out of the pose as you listen to your body's needs. Shoulders relaxed. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath. Sighing out. Relax the belt a little, bend the knee, taking the loop off the foot, bringing the foot towards the earth and then slowly extending the leg, and we change sides, bending the opposite leg, knee, towards your chest, looping the belt around your foot, and then find the comfortable position for your leg. Listen to your body's needs, bending the knee if you need. If the hamstring's quite tight, you will probably have to bend the knee. In a good yin yoga class, if people are listening to the needs of their body, knowing what the pose is for, so we're listening into the hamstrings, everyone will be in a slightly different position, because everybody's body is unique and each day it's different, its needs are different, even different times of the day. Softening more and more in each exhale, the shoulders, the arms, the back, the face, the torso. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath before sighing out, relaxing the knee to the chest. Taking the belt away and moving it to the side. Allow the leg to extend and move towards the earth. Relaxing the legs, relaxing the back, the arms. And now rolling onto your side, using your hands to slowly help you up into a seated position. And then coming onto the knees. We're going to move into sleeping swan. So coming to a tabletop position, we're going to start with the right leg. And we're going to bring it forward. Now your body, the foot may come in parallel to the knee, but listen to your body. My body doesn't. I lengthen back through the leg. To begin, I extend up, open the chest, and then slowly bring the belly towards my thigh, walking the hands forward and then relaxing, forehead down. You may wish to place a pillow under that right hip. Breathing deep and softening the body, the muscles, the fascia, the connective tissue. To make it easier, you can place a block under your forehead or a pillow. Again, listening to your body's needs. And if you have sciatica at the moment, you won't be able to move into the pose as much. So again, a comfortable position. You want healing to occur. We want to overwrite any abuse that we do to our body. And how do we do this? We do it by nurturing it. Soften the lower spine. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath. Sighing out, pressing the palms into the earth, slowly raising the head, walking the hands back towards your hips, releasing that front knee, coming back into tabletop. Inhale, some cat cows, dropping the belly towards the earth, looking up. Exhale, pushing the back up towards the sky, the heavens. Inhale, the front of your torso towards the earth, crown and tailbone towards the heavens. Exhale, push the back up towards the heavens, dropping the head, dropping the tailbone. Two more with your breath. And now bringing the left knee forward, lengthening back the right leg, bringing your fingertips onto the earth, onto the mat, shoulders back and away from the ears. Inhale, look up towards the heavens, the moon. Exhale, bending the elbows, slowly bringing the belly onto the thighs. Remembering if you need a cushion under the hips, under the forehead, or a block,
Make this your practice, your time, your space to honor you. Not pushing the body, just allowing the muscles to release, allowing them to soften. And understanding a body's difference in different sides of the body. Some sides are tighter, stronger, weaker, more flexible. In yoga, we just become aware of what the body, where it is. We notice our feelings, emotions, sensations, accepting them as they are, not trying to change them. It is a time, a space to connect in with the body, connect in with your soul, ground your soul and your spirit fully in our body, and create a safe container for your soul. Create space for it to reside. Clear of faults, so that its wisdom can come through. A few more deep breaths. One last deep breath, sighing out. Press the palms into the earth, slowly raise the shoulders ahead, walking the hands back to the hips, bringing the knee back, coming to the kneeling position. And now we move into our last pose, which is a reclined shoelace, so moving onto the back. Feet planted on the earth, knees bent. Allow the right ankle to come to the opposite knee, creating a figure four. And then you can use your belt by threading it through if you need, or use your hand, whichever is most comfortable for you. And then bring the left knee towards the chest. Creating softness in the lower back. be soft. And that right knee to fall out to wherever is comfortable for your body. Your unique bone stretching. Your unique musculature system. And Sagittarius is the seeker. Seek the comfortable position for your body. Seek your body's wisdom. Meeting its needs. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath, releasing the hands, bringing the left foot down towards the mat, releasing the right leg, and bringing that foot towards the mat, and we're going to change sides. So bringing the left ankle to the right knee. Bringing, interlacing your fingers behind your thigh. Relaxing the left hip out. The word yoga comes from the Sanskrit word yug, which is yoke, and it's about combining the body and the soul, the mind and the spirit. It helps us clear the mind. Come in contact with your soul and your spirit. Relaxing our muscles and our nervous system. Connect us with your true being. So when challenges come, and they will, that we can navigate them with more ease, with more grace. When joyful experiences come, we can move into them. You can trust in your soul's wisdom. Be brave and courageous to take the steps forward we need in life. Use our hearts and souls to discern what is right for us. With a clear mind, it's easier to notice the intuitions, they're clearer, so we can follow our intuition with a knowingness. One last deep breath. Exhale, release the hands, release the legs. And now we move into Shavasana. So any Shavasana pose that's comfortable for your body, whether that's feet up against a wall, or if you want to bend the knees and place a bolster underneath, just move into that position there. Allow space between the arms and the body. Palms facing up towards the moon. Allow space between the legs. The body relaxes. And allow the magical energies of the moon to absorb, assimilate into your body. As you breathe in through the nose, the chest, the belly, allowing the body, the belly to be soft. Breathing like a baby. And as we soften, we become more receptive, open to wisdom from the heavens, the universe. As we absorb this magical moon energy, receiving its support to help us under the waxing moon, giving us motivation, momentum, commitments to take those inspired steps towards our goals. And in Shavasana, we don't even need to think what those goals are. Just allow those energies to move into your conscious. And over the next week, next month, the wisdom will become conscious. Few more deep breaths. One last deep breath. Sighing out, allowing gentle movements in the fingers, the toes, the wrists and the ankles. Bending the knees, feet to the mats, and then bring the knees towards the belly. You can rock gently side to side, giving a nice gentle massage to the lower back, and then stop at center. Inhale, exhale, bring the head over the chest, and slowly rock back and forth as we create momentum. And when it's right for your body, move in to a seated position.
Noticing how you feel. Noticing the relationship you nurtured with yourself today. Becoming aware of the connection with everyone watching today, or at any time, because there's no such thing as time or space. Whenever the people are watching, they're connecting. We are connecting as a community of like-minded souls and kindred spirits, aligning with the natural cycles of the earth, connecting with the wisdom of our ancestors. Bringing the palms out to the side, gathering up the energy we've created today. Notice sensations in the palms as you raise the arms up towards Mother and Grandmother Moon, looking up, giving thanks for the healing, the cleansing, the wisdom and blessings. Bring the palms together in prayer pose, and then down, bringing everything down through heart center to your heart. One last deep breath as we close this practice today, and exhale out. Thank you for joining me here today. Thank you for aligning with the natural cycles, for investing in your well-being. From my heart to yours, Grandma Hagwiv, Asfala Mashal, and you. I'm a Cree, Gajee the Cree. Namaste, Sloan, Augustana. Goodbye and blessings on you from the divine. If you like this video, please press the like button, share it to anyone that you might feel may benefit from these videos. And if you want to continue on this journey to align with the natural cycles, press the subscribe button. Have a wonderful week.